Party is Google's other text-to-image generator that can accurately reflect world knowledge. In addition to Imagen, Google has another text-to-image generator called Party that also strives for photorealism, but by using a different family of generative models. Pathway's autoregressive text-to-image, known as Party, uses an autoregressive model that can benefit from advances in large language models. For comparison, Google's Imagen uses diffusion, where the model learns to convert a pattern of random dots into images. On the other hand, Party's approach first converts a collection of images into a sequence of code entries, similar to puzzle pieces. A given text prompt is then translated into these code entries, and a new image is created. This approach takes advantage of existing research and infrastructure for large language models, such as PaLM, and is critical for handling long, complex text prompts and producing high-quality images. Google found that Party can manage long, complex prompts that accurately reflect world knowledge, are composed of many participants and objects with fine-grained details and interactions, and adhere to a specific format and style. Like with Imagen, Google has opted not to release Party's models, code, or data for public use without further safeguards in place. All images are watermarked in the bottom right corner. Current models like Party are trained on large, often noisy image-text datasets that are known to contain biases regarding people of different backgrounds. This leads such models, including Party, to produce stereotypical representations of, for example, people described as lawyers, flight attendants, homemakers, and so on, and to reflect Western biases for events such as weddings. Google is exploring this area and thinks tools like these can unlock joint human-computer creativity. Robotic artificial intelligence system improves cell culture recipes for regenerative medicine to autonomously determine the optimal conditions for growing replacement retina layers necessary for vision. The AI controlled a trial and error process spanning 200 million possible conditions that succeeded in improving cell culture recipes used in regenerative medicine. This achievement, published in the scientific journal eLife, is just one example of how the automated design and execution of scientific experiments can increase the efficiency and speed of life science research in general. Research in regenerative medicine often requires numerous experiments that are both time-consuming and labor-intensive. In particular, creating specific tissue from stem cells, a process called induced cell differentiation, involves months of work, and the degree of success depends on a wide range of variables. Finding the optimal type, dose, and timing of reagents, as well as optimal physical variables such as pipette strength, cell transfer time, and temperature is difficult and requires an enormous amount of trial and error. Because minute differences in physical conditions have a significant impact on quality and because inducing cell differentiation takes weeks to months of time in culture, the impact of a tiny difference in timing on day 3 might not be detected for several months. To make this process more efficient and practical, the research team set out to develop an autonomous experimental system that can determine the optimal conditions and grow functional retinal pigment layers from stem cells. Retinal pigment epithelium cells were chosen because degeneration of these cells is a common age-related disorder that leaves people unable to see. Equally important, transplanted retinal pigment epithelium layers have already been shown to have some clinical success. For autonomous experiments to be successful, the robot must repeatedly produce the same series of precise movements and manipulations, and the AI must be able to evaluate the results and formulate the next experiment. The new system accomplishes these goals using a general-purpose humanoid robot named Mahalo, capable of highly precise life science experimental behavior. Mahalo is controlled by AI software that uses a newly designed optimization algorithm to determine which parameters should be changed and how they should be changed to improve differentiation efficiency in the next round of experiments. Researchers input the necessary protocols for generating RPE cells from stem cells into Mahalo, and while RPE cells were successfully generated in all experiments, efficiency was only 50%. Thus, for every 100 stem cells, only about 50 became RPE cells. After establishing this baseline, the AI initiated the optimization process to determine the best conditions among all chemical and physical parameters. What would have taken humans over 2.5 years to complete only took the robotic AI system 185 days. This resulted in a 90% rate of differentiation efficiency. Practically, these cells displayed many of the typical biological markers that would make them suitable for transplant into an eye of a damaged RPE cell layer. The success of the new system goes beyond the immediate results, because combining a precision robot with the optimization algorithms will enable autonomous trial and error experiments in many areas of life science, not just for RPE cells. However, the researchers emphasize that the goal of the study is not to replace human lab workers with robots. Using robots and artificial intelligence for carrying out experiments will be of great interest to the public. The vision is for people to do what they are good at, which is being creative, and robots with artificial intelligence can do the trial and error parts of the experiments that require repeatable precision and take up a lot of time but do not require thinking. Algorithms fuse this information to update the 3D model of the environment and highlight potential locations of the target item, allowing the robot to ascertain the size and shape of the object. Then, the system reasons about the object in the pile and the RFID tag locations to determine which item to remove, with the goal of finding the target item with the fewest moves. The robot is unsure how objects are oriented under the pile, or how a squishy item might be deformed by heavier items pressing on it, but it overcomes this challenge with probabilistic reasoning, using what it knows about the size and shape of an object and its RFID tag location to model the 3D space that the object is likely to occupy. As it removes the item, it also uses reasoning to decide which item would be best to remove next. After it removes the object, the robot scans the pile again and uses the new information to optimize its strategy to pick the next item. This reasoning, as well as its use of RF signals, gave FuseBot an edge over state-of-the-art systems that only used vision. The team ran more than 180 experimental trials using robotic arms and piles with household items like office supplies, stuffed animals, and clothing. They varied the sizes of piles and numbers of RFID-tagged items in each pile. FuseBot extracted the target item successfully 95% of the time, compared to 84% of the time with other robotic systems. It accomplished this using 40% fewer moves and was able to locate and retrieve targeted items more than twice as fast. FuseBot could be applied in a variety of settings because the software that performs its complex reasoning can be implemented on any computer because it only needs to communicate with a robotic arm that has a camera and antenna. In the future, the researchers are planning to incorporate more complex models into FuseBot so it performs better on deformable objects. Beyond that, they want to explore different manipulations, such as a robotic arm that pushes items out of the way. Future iterations of the system could also be used with a mobile robot that searches multiple piles for lost objects.